streaming or whatever. It's recording on the server. Okay. So it's recording to the game.
Yeah.
You've got two girls here.
Yeah, so I'm gonna, as soon as I was lying, we'll just see if they'll do their stats upstairs.
Test. Paul, we're all good to go. We just need someone upstairs to.
Just see if we can get one of these girls. Sorry? Well,
that'd be alright to come, I guess.
We're advertising for one more.
Oh, yeah?
Oh.
Safe up
there? I hope so.
We'll see. Sure. Are you just doing that?
Only a bit. Use your heights.
Last year, the fullback would never have gone it deep. That's a great, great idea.
All right. So wake up, Marv. We're on the air now, buddy.
Excellent.
A little bit of technical difficulty, but we're all set to go. So we got Trent, Excalibur versus Queens. And what can you tell me about Queens here, Coach?
Queens have, surprisingly, as national champions the last two seasons, have lost last week to Ottawa 3-0.
3-0.
And apparently one striker scored all three goals, so that's a real bit of a surprise for us. I'm quite convinced that there was considerable improvement in our varsity team this year. The results from previous campaigns have been not so successful away from town. This year they're doing extremely well. They're three games away, the first three games of the season. It was a one loss, one draw, and one win. So that's successful. Trent Excalibur Ladies head coach Joe Muldoon is in New Jersey this weekend to his brother's 25th wedding anniversary.
Oh no.
So, very capable coaching replacements. And Vic Rocha, and Kevin Reed, and Jeff Selkirk. Vic Rocha is new to Trent University, but not new to the city. He's the head coach of.
Sorry, Mark.
He's the head coach of Beaver City's under 21 men's side. And a technical coach for three of Peterborough City's youth teams, excellent guy, known vet for 2 or 3 years now. Very competent coach, and he's more than capable of holding our own here. I know that he's an attacking-minded coach, and hopefully that'll be successful with the teams today. So far in the match, of course, I believe we're somewhere near 25 minutes into the first half. We've conceded 3 corners to 1, but the team looks fit and playing very well. Their shape has been good. And I don't like this where we don't have too many players in midfield, but we're doing okay. We're playing uphill a little bit, but we're doing okay, keeping our shape up. So hopefully we can retain our confidence that we have going into this match.
Well, let's hope for a good game here, Marv. So the girls have been getting off to a good start this year compared to last.
They certainly have, that's for sure. Here, where are my notes here? Oh, I'm sorry about that. As I indicated earlier, the first 3 games away were, compared to last season, successful. And they beat one team 2-0. And just tied. That's a good save for our goalkeeper. They're extremely well so far in this match. And won a match away. So that's the team definitely playing with a lot more confidence this year. And I'm convinced that we're going to have a very good season. We're going to prove it by playing well against Queens today. Both teams playing 4-4-2. I think that's the system that suits our team so far today. I hope Joe's watching this match in New Jersey. And when he called last evening, he told me he would be. So, but he won't be home until late tomorrow evening. So we have another match, of course, tomorrow. We'll play RMC at 1 o'clock here at Trent. And hopefully we'll do well in that match as well. So this Queens team switched the ball very, very well. No wonder they've been champions 2 years in a row. Good defending, though. They're defending in depth and support. We likely would not have seen them play the ball back, as we just observed, to a support player. Last season that didn't happen very often. This year they're obviously beginning to use it. And when one of the center backs goes out to challenge, the other center back will drop into a deeper defensive role, which is obviously very good support for the defense.
The Trent girls are looking much stronger than they were last year. New goalie, though, too, for them this year.
Yes. I like the distribution. Again, that was an example of the distribution on the ground away from the pressure. So that's always helpful. And balls out to the flank. Not going to hurt us too much on the flank.
No. That's where you want to put it, right?
Exactly right. Ball comes from one side. They are obviously under pressure from that side. So we can attack off the other side as quickly as possible we can. I hear Coach Vic Rocha yelling out instructions to his team. And the goalkeeper off very quickly off the line. That's excellent. That's Emily Wiso. How is that pronunciation?
Emily Webb?
Webb's, is it?
No, Webb. Webb Marv.
Emily Webb. She's played very well so far.
Yes, she has. She had a little help from her friends there in the first few minutes when the ball went off the crossbar, but
Queens played the ball through the middle inside the 6-yard box several times early in the match, and the defense was capable of handling it, so that's always a good sign.
Exactly. Everyone's trying to get.
We didn't get that ball there.
Half break.
Half hour mark. Conceding a goal.
Oh, call back. Is the call on that one, Mark?
Yeah. I didn't see a flag go up here, but
I think she was offside.
The flag. Oh, so excellent. Not so bad after all.
No, we'll take.
Excellent. We'll take that every time.
We'll take those calls for us, eh, Mark?
Yes, for sure. It shows a bit of a weakness getting to the ball first in the back row.
Yes.
You have to be there first.
However, by not being there first, Marv, they made her offside, thus negating the goal.
I would take a chance and get there first.
You and me both.
Absolutely.
Sometimes you're not so lucky, eh?
No.
You get one of those hand of God plays like Henri there.
Queens are not afraid to push the ball around in the back three or four. They as well are playing 4-4-2. We seem to be reduced to low ball situations out of our.
Good flag.
Excellent.
Trying to get in.
It's worth the effort there. Very good try. Well done. A bit of a scare for Queens, I think, there.
Yeah, it's good heads-up play.
She has to use this ball.
Was Carly Dunway there with a good run?
And she's done that. She's used it to the flank.
Second-year player, Carly.
Second-year, good.
Yeah.
Excellent. Yeah, I recall her from last season. This is good shape. This is very good shape for this team. They've got the support in the back.
It's going to be Carly and... Number 12 there, Shannon O'Brien, were the dynamic duo of the running last year, it seemed.
Yes, as you recall, we watched them pretty closely last season.
Yeah.
And were impressed with them as well.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't an extremely successful season, other than the fact that they began to learn as the matches were won. And I believe got better, except for the last couple of games last season.
Is that Catherine Monroe coming off?
Unfortunately, we don't have any numbers with these.
I've got all the answers here, Marv.
You've got all the answers.
Yeah.
Excellent. So you have the numbers for this list of mine.
I do.
You're a good lad sometimes.
Depends who you ask, Marv. Well, actually, that might have been Abby Lloyd, number 15, coming off. We need those big signs like in FIFA where they hold the change boards.
And your eyesight has to be a heck of a lot better than mine. It's well in to win the ball. Excellent, excellent. I think they're playing far too much down right flank, but we have had a lot of pressure coming from our left. So, the Queen's right, of course. So maybe that's the reason that there's some play, if indeed they're under instructions to play down the right flank. I like the warm-up they're doing, though. The young ladies are warmed up there.
All together there?
Yeah, they're warming up well.
On a windy, cold day, it's helpful.
Yeah. Thank you, that's excellent.
Oh, my mistake. Yeah, it was Catherine Monroe coming off. Number 5, Catherine Monroe came off. And Catherine was replaced by number 19, Jen Paulus, who's from the team last year as well.
I see Coach is playing every ball there, standing there playing every ball. His movement is, he's involved in everything. Maybe that's why Joel isn't being him and his coaching staff.
Well, it's always nice that you know you can leave home, nothing's going to happen, right?
Well, and hopefully something very good happens.
Absolutely.
If I recall, last year we were under pressure at the beginning of almost every game.
Yes.
And it took us such a long time to begin to understand that maybe we could play a little bit in their half as well.
I know they did a lot of work, too, in the offseason last year, playing, even just scrimmaging together. They'd all show up at the...
Training sessions, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I don't know if they did any drills, but I know they were definitely for sure scrimmaging, playing with each other on the pitch.
Mm-hmm. I was fortunate enough last season to do a couple of sessions with the team, and they were very helpful. They took instructions extremely well, and I appreciated them. The work rate that they put in.
Mm-hmm.
They seem to enjoy themselves as well. So, not, obviously not just in my sessions, but they enjoy being with each other. And as a team, that's the way they have to be. So, a lovely long throw. Too bad we couldn't get on the end of it. Look at the work rate of Shannon O'Brien. Very nice.
Put some pressure on here, Mark.
The halfback number 10 went in to make the challenge, and the fullback immediately supported her from behind. That's a very good understanding of defensive responsibilities.
Paulus stripped of the ball there. Oh, she got it back.
Well, she has to use it now.
Nifty little.
Take it till you're challenged. The ball must have been rolling out. I'm not sure what the crown is on this pitch, but the ball sure rolls a long way.
Well, it's the problem of the synthetic pitches, right? The ball just rolls and rolls and rolls.
Especially if there's any crown on it at all. And of course, you need the crown.
Absolutely.
But our girls, when they train here, they have to be aware of that, obviously.
It looks like your girl's coming in here, Marv. Emily Larkin.
Ah, yes, I like this little fullback here.
Replacing
Kayla
DiNardo.
I still believe that she's a halfback. I really do. She has such good distribution. But she's coming in here at left fullback. I like Emily. She's a
little spark plug.
Unfortunately, this is her last season.
Yes,
at
but
Trent, she graduated, I think. So, I'm a fan of Emily's, primarily because she wins so many balls and her distribution is excellent. In other words, her vision is very, very good.
You almost want that as a defender, though, Marv.
I beg your pardon?
You almost want that in a defender, though. Vision able to see the ball, see the playing.
Oh, of course.
It helps in every position, but I mean...
Yes, of course. You have to put it this way, son. Attack wins games. Defense wins championships. We take Canada and France in the Olympics. What do we have? Canada had four shots at goal. One or two on target, and we won 1-0 after possession would have been better than 85% to France. And yet defense won that match.
Right. No lead is safe unless you play defense.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And,
you can't really argue with the air there, Coach.
And should I dare get into the American game with Canada? Heavens, totally, totally unacceptable. But we never complain about the officials.
No, the official never loses the game for bad calls.
Absolutely not.
They're always right 100% of the time. Like
wink,
the weatherman, right?
Wink, wink, right.
Yeah.
There goes Emily already. Look at, she's won that ball. Excellent, Emily. Yeah, excellent. Not afraid to attack. I like bravery. I really do. Look at how quickly she gets back. Look at how quickly Emily gets back. That's excellent. She'll probably be embarrassed.
Well, we said this last year. She sure is speedy for one of the shorter players.
Yeah. She's a meter ahead in her mind.
Mm-hmm.
There's a little bit of a gap between the strikers and midfield here. There's a little gap there, that's for sure. But what that does when there's a gap between midfield and strikers, it forces the strikers to come back to get involved in the game. And of course, it should be the midfield that's coming out to support strikers, at least one or two of them.
Well, if you got four across, right?
Yeah, exactly. But they're playing a flat back four and a flat four in midfield. Now, as you know, I think I told you in the past that I believe in a diamond in midfield.
Yes.
One more committed to attacking and one more committed to sitting in front of the back four. But
almost is gone.
The idea was great. But your players will determine the best systems for you to play.
Yeah.
And the circumstance of the game, of course.
Absolutely.
That's why I like Joe Muldoon's senior, Peterborough City senior ladies team is the best team that I've seen to keep their shape with and support. I've told Joe this several times that they're the very best at keeping their shape and using the ball very well.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
She's right on her tail, too.
Yeah. Well, that's the pressure we were talking about before. Watch this long throw from Emily here. See if we win it. That's the important thing.
We were there. It's tough to tell, though.
Yeah.
But the first bouncer off the throw-in was really good.
She's using the ball to support. That's excellent. That's excellent. I think the difference is that in the past we've almost over 50% of the balls were long balls, which we had to chase.
Yeah.
And now it seems to be more of a build-up. They're definitely becoming more of a build-up system of play, which, as you know, I like that very much. Possession is 9/10 of the law. They support all over the place. This is very good shape. A little too deep there.
Didn't give her much to work with there in the corner.
But the defensive position she took up was excellent.
Absolutely.
I'll use it. Vic's Roach is involved in everything. You can see his body motion. I wonder if the fans can hear him, or at least the anyone on the end of his mic here. They've definitely gone into a deeper sweeper system, you know. Kelsey White seems to be playing a little deeper. See that, Brendan? She's definitely taken up a sweeper role as opposed to a stopper role.
And that adjustment's due to just the way the game's panning out, Coach? Or?
Oh, absolutely. Yes. I'm a firm believer in support in the back. Not support all over the pitch, but particularly in the back, having played in the back, back to the old, all of my career for all intents and purposes.
Look at Emily step back there.
Yes, and the sweeper went back to support the to support the challenge, which was really quite good.
Little shiver there on the field.
Yeah, let them know they're there.
Oh yeah, so they don't back up into you. It's more for safety than anything else.
I don't
right,
think
Mark?
That wall's really 10 yards away. Do you think it is?
Oh, he's moving it now, Mara.
Yeah,
he heard you.
Pretty long strides. That's pretty long strides. You must have size 14 boots on. However, no complaints about officials.
Absolutely not.
Actually, they're doing a good job here. Don't tell them I said so, but they're doing a good job here. And again, the wall did not jump. I wonder why that would be. Again, I'm a firm believer in a wall jumping. That's, Joe, do you hear me? A wall should jump. This main strike here, 18? One in the middle.
For which mark?
For Queens.
With the short hair there, Marv?
Yeah, the deepest striker.
18, yes, that's
18?
Your number.
Yeah. Understanding that's Jackie Tissier? Tassier?
Tassier, I'd say.
Tassier, is it? Yeah, she's the striker. She's the real danger. And there's a midfielder, Riley Fillion.
Quick ball.
Who's also a real danger. Gosh, I wish this wall would jump. I really do. That's only putting three players in the wall. That's okay. Well, that's fine. Steps are a little shorter this time. Ah, they wanted to play a little short one out to the flank there.
Sneaky, sneaky.
Yeah. You see Coach Vic just called for one of the fullbacks to look at that, see if it goes wide.
Knocks it right down, eh? 16.
Good trap. Well done. Well done. Take it on. It's well done. Go on in and win it. Go on, had a good. Well done. Get a piece of it. Look at the work rate. That's excellent work rate. Very nice. I don't want to read that girl's number.
They've retweeted us.
On the right flank. Use it. Well done. Oh. When you're under immediate pressure like that, you really must get rid of the ball quickly, which has a lot to do with vision, of course.
Absolutely.
Another lovely long throw, which we've won. I think they're too tight to each other right now. They've shifted too deep.
Good defensive play.
Yes. She's had an excellent match. She's down now.
Looks like a little bit of a boot to a head.
Wow. Tough little girl.
We got a little replay here.
Oh.
Shakes it off though and gets back into it.
Amazing. Now we've got to shift that ball off to the left flank. We're in possession. Emily really should be coming out of there. There's no sense in marking them when we have the ball. It's the see. Emily should be the outlet here. Oh, coming out so very well. Keeper.
Oh.
Ooh, boy, another corner. Queens look good side, but they definitely don't look like national champions so far.
No, not at all. But still early in the season, Marv. Still tons of time to go.
Yes, but at the pace that Trent Excalibur ladies are going, we're going to have a good season.
Absolutely. That's the other thing to look at it too, right?
Mm-hmm.
Two times champions, 0-0. Not a bad...
Not bad at all. I'll bet they're very disappointed at conceding 3-0 last weekend. I don't suppose someone would be fibbing with the old coach, do you?
No, Marv.
No, absolutely.
Players are always 100% honest with the coach. Always.
Yeah.
Yes, coach.
You don't know.
I obeyed
curfew.
I obeyed curfew, coach. Absolutely. I've been training in the off season.
Sure, absolutely. Ran 10 kilometers yesterday.
Exactly.
I used to have to keep up with some of my lads on my bicycle, for goodness sakes, to keep together. Now you see, this little halfback here, number 10, she should be up the pitch. Striker should be forward. That's it, Emily.
That's the half. So at the end of the half, Marv.
Nil-nil. That's very good. I know they put the ball in the net once, but supposedly it was called back for an infraction. And I'm quite satisfied that the ladies are doing well. And it's a good thing we're a second half team.
Absolutely.
There's a second half, you know. There's a second half.
Yeah, we gotta go give them the sheets, though.
Are we off here now?
We are.
Okay. Good luck.
I don't know how low the camera is.
Jesus, Bill's done marvelous. C60 over here. Athletic director.
I've done a ridiculous amount.
Oh, Christ. You've seen this pitch when I was here.
I heard it was just a mud bat.
Like a mud ball.
Yeah.
I thought you sound like Reba to me.
Marv, there's only so much I could do.
I know we're spinning blades, yeah.
You need another man in here.
Yeah.
Where's the elder gentleman that we were last year?
Dylan?
Yeah, where's he?
I'm not sure, Mar.
He is definitely helping.
Yeah, we're gonna advertise for another position this week for somebody to come in, but
there we go. Heading up.
Preferably if you know something about computers.
Yes.
Yes.
A huge benefit. Good thing we've got that.
I'd love to hear that conversation.
So, Marv, pizza's on you today? Is that what I hear?
If you want.
No.
I do want pizza.
Don't forget, Queens lost last week 3-0.
Oh, wow.
Ottawa.
Not the dynasty they were last year.
No.
Yeah.
bad Domino's. I love Domino's.
Paul, you want some pizza?
What?
You want some pizza?
No, I do.
Just wait.
Stop. So, men sort of have the Mexican sheep, and then they're passed the across the queens. How are their fishers prepared?
They're pretty finicky about everything. Like, they're like, oh, like, go fix the corner flags as well. They need to be on the corners, like, typically with, like, the flag, like, on the corners. It's like, okay, well, they're going over and they're like, these weights need to be heavier and stuff like that. Like, holy. But,
fair enough. Like, to be honest, though, no, that's the regulation of the weight.
But yeah, I said, you know, when I tied the nets down, they're like, that's fine.
Why need to get so many schedules?
Last year, 6 mil.
So far, so good.
It's windy,
yes.
No, I just want.
Lost 1-0 charm.
Because they didn't know about the lacrosse game. It's like, oh yeah, just leave the nets out there, that'll be fine. I'll put the wheels back on. I was like, well, there's a lacrosse game at 5:30. It's like, oh. I guess we'll just get to the lacrosse game next week.
Very cold.
Yes, go. But yeah, I would be a little happier if we didn't have 3 jobs each to do.
Yeah. Do you ever see much come back?
Still giving something for the guy game. Lacrosse, Jesse will come in.
Okay, you're up and running there, Mark. Frozen anyways. Oh no, we're good.
We on now?
You're going, Mark.
And we just kicked off for the second half of Queen's University at Trent University, and it's 0-0 after the end of the first half, with both teams playing pretty well, hopefully playing as much possession as possible. With a bit of a wind out there today, at this particular pitch, the ball rolls and rolls and rolls and rolls. However, I'm impressed with the effort and the way that Trent and Excalibur ladies are playing. They're playing very high line, but defensively, their shape is very, very good. And I don't like this, though. Wow. Oh. We almost conceded a goal here right early in the second half here. In the first minute.
Play fast.
However, I guess I could be forward to both teams would be playing much for best position football on the back, by the way, to Anthony Larkin. Who tried to use the ball down the flank. And another throw. We've had so many darn throw-ins today.
Never fear, Marv, I'm back.
You're a good lad sometimes.
I've heard that a couple times now.
Yeah. Well, I use my head once in a while. It's 2v2 in the middle. Wow. I wonder why that would be, that we would be under pressure so much at the start of a game or the start of the second half. It's almost a duplicate of the first half. Oh, look at this. This is excellent shape. The two strikers are pretty close together, but I'm not sure one of them shouldn't be playing off the other one. Shannon O'Brien seems to be the more forward striker. The objective is to push the ball down the flanks, which is always good.
Absolutely.
You fellas a bit cool up here in the booth?
It's a little chilly, Marv. Yeah. It's a little chilly.
So it's not just me.
No.
I like the way Trent is trying to put pressure on him as immediately as possible.
Oh no, there's that dangerous striker again.
The keeper's got to come. Oh. The linesman's flag is up for an offside there. And
another lucky break.
A goalkeeper... must have noticed that because she didn't come off her line very quickly at all. And she'd normally been playing very well, so. The Looks like she wants to take this kick, free kick, so that's good. That pushes more players up front.
Absolutely.
Up the pitch. I like that. That's a throw into Trent. Now, see if we can't win some of these throws. I know Coach Vic was telling me earlier that he wanted to make sure that we were aware that we should be winning all these all of our throws. That's well in. That's exceptionally well in.
Good steal there by Forster.
See, immediately, how quickly they get to the pressure. That's very good. Now, Emily's got to get, not Emily, but 11 here. Kayla has to get goal side here. Third base, I'm pretty sure she's capable of doing that. Second half. Looks like a nice little crowd here today for this match.
Yeah, it's nice to have a nice sea of green out there.
That's the roar of the sleeper. Excellent. Good positioning sense. Excellent. She's playing extremely well. Position. Look at them, the distribution very early and wide to the flank. Hard luck. The idea was excellent. The idea was just
absolutely
excellent. I really like and enjoy that very much.
Getting to think about the idea is a lot harder than actually.
Oh, you betcha. Especially on this pitch. I know it looks wonderful, but it's such a hard pitch to play football on. You see, they win their throw-ins, and we're at 50-50 balls with our throw-ins. Throw-in is possession, and we should be taking it.
Absolutely. It is a little chilly today, Marv.
Yeah, it is cool.
I think I saw today in the weather it's going to go down to -1 tonight.
Which is ridiculously unacceptable.
Absolutely.
Can we not win one of their throw-ins for a change here?
Oh, almost. I think she's a little surprised that.
That very quick throw-in too from Queens. Excellent idea.
Good block.
And Raven gets stuck in there.
It's Selkirk. She was very good last year too with
yes.
Getting right in.
Yes, I recall commenting on her several times, you and I, last year. What I noticed too, that's quite a bit different with Trent, is it's not just one person who closed down the ball, at least two people, and on that occasion three people tried to close down the ball very quickly.
Well, extra pressure. And it's paying off. I mean, it's 0-0 still.
You're darn right. It really does.
52 minutes gone. Monroe's come back in, it looks like.
Yes.
And as is DiNardo.
What happens sometimes is that when they're defending, a halfback will go so deep that they're really taking the position of the fullback. Mm-hmm. And the fullback then will stand off. And it'll look like they are halfbacks doing a fullback's job. The fullback has to tell that halfback to get the heck out of here. Get up the park so that I can give you the ball outside. Then we'll retain possession. I mean, I'm trying to be good, but tactically it's not like that. The goalkeeper got their hands to it.
Oh!
The goalkeeper actually had the palm of her hands to this ball. And perhaps should have punched the ball. So we conceded a goal here in 9-10 minutes in the second half. It's too bad. Oh, That's excellent. I like this number 22.
Brittany Forrester?
Brittany Forrester, yeah.
Good little player. Nice little girl, too. She was in a couple of my classes last year.
She did. That's unacceptable. You see how quickly that she that the pressure came there. That's very good.
Long ball. Oh, to get to that dangerous striker there, coach.
Yeah. It's number 18.
Jackie Tessier.
Yeah, that's the danger girl, okay. Coach Muldoon was telling me about her. He's obviously aware of her. And he's made his staff aware of her.
Queens in the attack.
Yes.
Call for the offset again.
We haven't been out of our end much this time.
No, and has there been a change in tactics from Queens, coach, or is it just...
Nothing that I notice. They still seem to be playing, obviously, they look to me like they're playing a diamond in midfield, in central midfield.
Yeah, I can see that too.
Yeah. One more attacking again, and one more defensive midfielder in front of their back four. I'm pretty sure the Trent are still playing a flat.
I think you're right,
coach. You think I'm right?
Okay, coach, you're right. Coach is always right. Queens went up the flank.
They used the ball very well, though. Went twice.
DiNardo chasing her down.
Yes.
Oh. Well, that's Selkirk, getting in the way.
That's very, very good defending. That's very good defending. I'm impressed. I think they're doing very well. What they have to do now is keep their heads and start to use the ball. We never seem to run out of our back third with the ball, even though there's space in front of us. We should never run out if they're being challenged. But definitely if there's space in front of you, then take the ball in. Lose your attack, whoever that player came off of, lay it to them. I think Queens are playing with confidence right now. We're a little shaky, to be quite honest.
They seem to have lost the pressure here, coach.
Yes, yes.
No longer challenging the ball.
See, there's that. That's that holding midfielder in front of the back four. She's decided that she can use that big space in the front there, in front of her.
First pass there, coach.
Yes, yes, and that ball was still in there.
That was still in view.
The markings on throw-ins is not exceptional. I would like to see the marking on Queen's throw-ins a lot tighter. We seem to be standing off and allowing them to retain possession much too easily. I don't. Quite honestly, I don't think there's a feeling of loss or anything here. I think they're a little shaken by the goal. But they're not, I don't think they're taking it anywhere near a defeat attitude.
not a degree to coach?
Of course you do. Yeah, you see, we're definitely in a super system. A little touch. Look how quick these three girls, the two girls, press them down. That's terrific.
That dangerous striker just seems to be.
Yeah, I've seen
everywhere.
Just rolled out of there. Yeah,
there's another substitution coming.
There's definitely a danger girl here. I wonder if Excalibur are going to change their system.
Well, Donardo and Larkin are both coming out.
Both full backs.
And Paulus and. Paulus is coming in.
You see how deep this young lady here, number 5?
Monroe?
Yeah, has dropped here. Goal kick. I don't really believe she should be dropping that deep. She should be a target player, which is up the park for her.
So Abby Lloyd also came in as well.
And support run and a ball into the box. The idea was right. They're keeping their system in the back four.
Good pressure.
Yeah, see how important that job of the sweeper is.
Long ball.
Distribution probably off to the right here. See this young lady here, Catherine Monroe.
Catherine Monroe?
Yes, she really should be deeper on the second when the goalkeeper regains possession. Well, a good pressure. Very good pressure on the keeper. Excellent. Now we're moving up the park. Good stuff. Now, see, the left fullback should be going much deeper. Excellent. That's excellent. This is far more effective position here. Good try. Try to knock that ball back inside.
So it's down. Good. Down.
This stopper marking number 18 and sweeper and support behind it. I like that idea very much. I think I definitely would drop one of these strikers into that hole in the middle. You see that hole there in the middle, guys?
Yes.
That's where that second striker should be. Either that or the offensive midfielder. Somebody has to be in that space in midfield.
Fill the gaps, eh?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. That's where possession is gained from.
Dunwoody knocks the ball out.
See how easily they win that throw in? That really shouldn't happen, guys.
So, Abby Lloyd will throw the ball in here for Trent there, coach.
Let's see if we can't retain possession here somehow. You see the difference in the marking that they're doing than we're doing? How tight it is compared to what we've been doing?
They're also a step in front of us as opposed to behind.
All right. That's a horse race there.
Tessier
and number 18 has just won it again. And what
great
a
defense.
How very well read. Very well read. Excellent.
Oh, Dunwoody and O'Brien again.
Yeah,
dynamic duo up there.
She's a strong little lady, that's for sure. I've watched her for several years in River City, and she's just kept improving and improving. And she's a little tiger. That's what she is.
You have.
I've always enjoyed that kind of player.
Sam Miranda there fighting for the ball in the flank.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like he got some grit up on the front there. Well, coach.
She certainly has that. That's for sure. Just use it.
Back to Webb.
Now the halfback can show.
Oh. Tough break.
Not that we're biased in any way, but gosh, I'd like to see I'd like to see a win here by Excalibur. Oh yeah, the joke for that one, young lady.
No, oh, I see.
Isn't that a great understanding of two players, eh?
Oh, yes. Nifty little move for the goal.
That's a heck of a goal. It really is. Number 18, eh? That's the goal. In the 20-minute mark. Number 18 is a really good little player.
Tessier,
very good player.
She
just sailed right through our back line.
She controls the ball well there too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's 2-0 now.
Tessier scored.
18 again.
I think so. Because they did score, unfortunately.
He's doing too much.
Brandon Paul, do you see the big gap that we're talking about here, lads, in the middle of midfield?
Sure do there, coach.
Sorry?
Said sure do.
We should be filling that gap. Somebody should be open. I think that maybe this second striker here should be in that a little deeper.
That was a handball, coach.
The ball play hand or hand play ball?
I guess it depends.
It's pretty
on
close in there. It's pretty hard to get your hand out of the way sometimes. As a defender, I always said that. When it was us.
I don't know. Just the arm shot up by itself. And like next push thing up. You know.
Push up, Trent. Push up. You know, there's still a big hole in the middle. Between the halfbacks and the strikers. Now, push up. Push up. We're so defensive minded that we're still concerned about their attack even though we have the ball. Look at how this number 12 here from Queens is opening right up and pulling our defenders right. Now, I hear the coach calling for pressure, which is great.
She saw Forrester.
Yeah. It was a free kick. Let's see what we can get from this. Oh gosh, I hope we keep somebody on the top of the D.
They see one lucky break. That's all they need, coach.
Yeah, just get one and we'll get another one right behind it. There should be a run from the flank into the ball.
Well, they have one set up on the far side there, coach.
Yeah, but I'm just talking this. The ball's coming from our left to our right. So it's much easier to hit a ball when you're facing it, moving towards it, from the right to the left, than it is from the other way.
Could you not drop behind the defender, let her run in?
Yeah. Yeah, get your head on. Oh, that defender came out extremely well. He attacked the ball. Very good defenders attack the ball. See, we're really playing three players here in the back, not counting the goalkeeper, of course, and they have only the one attacker. I know she's the danger, but still, it's only one attacker. The fullback should be coming up another 10 yards or so. Because we're really marking nobody when that happens.
Absolutely.
If their team's prepared to defend that team, we should be prepared to attack them that team. However, let's not give up the hope here. Let's pretend that we're second half team.
It's not over till it's over, right, Coach?
Well, we did get two goals, didn't we, in the second half?
Well, it's still 20 minutes left to play, yeah. Plus injury.
Well, at least we're playing in their half right now.
There you go.
Well, an effort at goal. Can't beat that. 25 minutes in the second half. Now you see this fullback, halfback here is coming back.
So Daniel Curdy with a long missed shot.
Abby Lloyd here, the right fullback, maybe should be attacking a little bit more. And the halfback maybe should have been out on the flank where that ball just went out. Leave the fullback to the inside job. And the halfback wider in order to retain possession if she's in the open more. Which is easy from here, mind you. It's easy here, guys.
Dunwoody's limping a bit there, Coach.
Yeah. I haven't kicked the ball long for a booth in my life.
Forrester, good play.
Yes. It's a horse race. Oh, it's got the pace. Well done. Well done. Well done.
Selkirk there with a great run back.
Yeah. Number 7? Yes, that's right.
Quick throw in, too.
Selkirk. Good pace. Very good pace. And the ball out wide. That's a good clearance. That's a good clearance. Yeah, that's okay. That's fine. So defensive minded here. We're down 2 goals. I would rather not protect the loss. I would rather go at them again.
I understand what you're saying, Coach.
Try to protect the loss. Think about attacking them.
Dunwoody's coming off here. Running in. I think she got her toe stepped on. She's running the outside of her right foot.
Excuse me.
Yeah, she's in vain. She's going right to...
Let's win this throw-in. Don't... Tight, Marky. Tight, tight, tight. Even Shannon's come back here. She's just won the ball, as a matter of fact, and laid it off extremely well. What a good idea. What an excellent idea. It's very good shape. Are our girls too nice, I wonder? Hey, what do you think, son? Are we too nice?
They're playing a bit nice there, Coach.
Yeah. That's well out by the keeper. I like that. And the distribution was excellent. Really, really. No, diagonal run from Shannon O'Brien down the flank. Excellent. The objective is great. Dark pitch. It's a great idea. A wonderful idea down the flank. Now, our fullback is here doing absolutely nothing. She's got to get tight to this number 4 here. That's right. That's the way you want to do it. Excellent. Oh, that's great. What a good idea. What a good idea.
In your way today, it looks like.
Okay. There you go. I get those back. Yeah, I know that. Oh, here she goes again.
Is that the same striker, coach?
Number 10.
Number 10.
Wow.
Tough break again for Trent.
Trent will change the system now. Hopefully.
Well, there's still 14 minutes left, coach.
What's the name of that number 10?
Number 10 from Queens?
Queens.
Calendar. It's tough to read some of the coaches' writing. Laura Calendar.
Laura Calendar.
That's correct.
She played that very well. Walked past the player and then knocked it low into the corner. An excellent goal. I think that we're showing them far too much respect here.
You think down by three, just go for it and hammer everything.
Oh, yeah.
But
I play in the other team's back third. That's where we want to be.
I'm going to go Trent again. O'Brien with a nifty little move there, coach.
Oh, this is a nice little player, this number 10. She just scored and now she's back in midfield.
No idea who number 17 is for us.
You saved that going out for a corner. Well done. If I had any advice at all, I really think, Brendan, that it would be just to get tighter sooner.
Just nice move up. Yeah. She got all that pitch in front of her, too.
And they're looking to look at the diagonal run here by Shannon O'Brien. Excellent. And I think they have to be aware that these good teams are quite capable of trying to beat them with a ball on the ground. That's a great ball. That's a lovely little ball. Take it. She had space there to take it if she wanted.
Oh, tough break for O'Brien. Those are always the worst ones, too.
Yep. Yeah. But you notice that that young lady had time to move the ball up, to bring a defender out, and then play it through.
It's Queen's moving the ball here on the far flank.
Yeah, we're having trouble getting out of our own end with possession. Although, we're still in the shape of the team is pretty good. The work rate is pretty good. I think the, oh goodness.
Wide kick, it's good.
A little more offensive-minded and not so afraid to make decisions, bad decisions in defense.
Far side?
Walking right to left.
Yeah, 17. That's her short side, anyways.
So number 5, Catherine Monroe. That's the girl she should be knocking it to. There's no marking with her at all.
Didn't work.
No, no, not. And now she's got to come deep. Good touch. Well, that's a great idea. Good idea. And you're getting great support. Wonderful support. I like this little Catherine Monroe number 5 here.
Yeah, she was a good player last year too, I remember.
Yeah, playing some good balls down the flank, good little midfielder. Let's get stuck in here and stick one in, ladies.
Ooh, just rolls out.
Hi, Diego. Good to see you, right? Now then, if we square across us here, we got 4 people marking 2, which isn't that bad. We have to win these. We have to win these balls. Any 50-50 balls, we must win them.
Good lot. Oh, we're there, coach.
Oh. I hear Vic yelling, no turn, no turn. This is exactly right, by the way.
So we solved the number 17 problem, coach.
You did?
It's Laura Davidson.
Laura Davidson.
That's correct. She came on for Carly Dunwoody when she was injured there, so.
See, they're not afraid to turn with the ball, Queens. Take theirs on to maintain possession. They have good marking here.
No.
I like this little Abby Lloyd here, right fullback here. Number 15, is that her? Yeah, that's
her. Yes.
Yeah.
She gets the Coach Marv stamp of approval.
Yes, she does. Yes.
She's a new player too.
I don't really see any weaknesses that can't be improved. That's for darn sure. Oh my goodness, that's a hard ball into the box there. Oh.
Jen Palace too.
Yeah.
Making sure Queens knows that they're in our house there. The little little touch, we'll say.
Yeah, we're condensed, all right. But when we're in possession, you really have to open up. That's where the space is to play the balls into. She's won that ball. That's excellent. That's
nice,
really well done.
So here we go. That's
tenacity for sure. Oh, and a good long ball through the middle. Oh, well. Get in. Run straight at her. She's so concerned about defending that she actually had an opportunity to put pressure on the ball.
Well, now she's put a little all. Nice little touch up by Lloyd.
Goes back for corner kick, I guess.
It's a corner kick, though.
We'll head it out. When in doubt, look it out.
Absolutely.
Let we've placed one girl here inside the 18, inside the D, which is always good. That's a danger area. Ah, and the sun's out again. We don't feel the heat in here very much, though.
No, absolutely not, Coach.
A nice little crowd here tonight. I like that. That's excellent.
Yeah, a nice little afternoon soccer.
Nice afternoon for a match.
We played about 80 minutes or so now, Coach, so...
Yes, about 5 minutes. I would think maybe perhaps 5 minutes left in the match. Is that what that's saying over there?
Well, that's the time we have. Who knows how much time the ref's going to give, right?
There hasn't been that many injuries or anything, though, so it's probably only a minute or so. Well, they take 30 seconds for each change.
Mm-hmm.
So, uh-oh. Well done.
Davidson putting on some pressure. The ball is just too quick for Queens. Jensu.
We might be twice as good as we were last year. They beat us 6-0 here last year.
Well, it's an improvement.
Yes, but we're going the right direction, but...
So Davidson?
Getting a little impatient, I guess.
Well, last year was a tough year, too. They had 15 first years last year, or something ridiculous like that.
I can't recall, actually.
I'll
look it up. Huh?
There was a high number of first-year players last year.
Yes, mm-hmm. I think we have 7, we call local Peterborough girls on the team this year.
Okay.
I'll look it up just to make sure. Not now, but later on this evening.